Can you believe it, Scoob? London at Christmas time. It was so nice of Daphne's dad to get us tickets to A Christmas Carol. It's like totally sold out.
Yeah, totally.
Wow, check it out, Scoob. That's the Queen of England.
The Queen?
Yep, and wow, she's wearing the crown jewels. The royal family only wears those for really special occasions. Man, those are expensive. Think how many double-decker pistachio and marshmallow burgers we could buy with that kind of money.
Even fish and chips?
I got you covered. There are ghosts in this play? It's called A Christmas Carol. I just thought it'd be a lot of singing. Man, I don't want to see ghosts. Ghosts are not relaxing. Plays are supposed to be relaxing. Shh. Like, wake me up when it's all over, eh, Scoob?
Sheesh. Oh, boy. Raggy?
Not now, Scoob. I'm hiding.
Raggy?
What is it? Zoinks. Man, the special effects in these new plays are, like, way too real.
My pelvic leg is just sticking out. Look at this. It's so not meant to be
the play's poltergeist pilfered those pearls.
Huh?
The ghost stole the crown jewels.
Everyone's like wearing fancy clothes, and then there's like Shaggy and Scooby just like casual wear.
Pardon me, Mr. Shaggy and Scooby?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
And you are part of the celebrated American crime-solving cabal, are you not?
That's the other three, man. We just hang out for the food.
You are most delightful. But seriously, we would appreciate your help in this matter. The crown jewels have been stolen by a fearsome ghost, and from what I have heard, that is your specialty.
Like, sorry, but we signed up for a midnight double-decker bus tour, and we can't miss that.
Oh, London!
Have you ever heard of the Royal Feast?
The Royal Feast? I thought that was just a legend.
Oh, I assure you, my gangly young friend, the Royal Feast is quite real. Every kind of food imaginable presented in the Royal Dining Room, and unlimited servings of everything.
Unlimited?
Everything?
That is what I'm
offering
everything. You if you help return the stolen jewels to me.
We'll do it.
Uh-huh.
This guy looks like the captain from the first
game. Let's go look for clues.
The pirate game.
Well,
Raggy!
Aw, man, I hate it when you point like that. Because when you point like that, it means something really scary is standing over my shoulder. Zoinks! I hate being right. Shall we?
Let's
run!
I already know what this. Eat that, get a cockroach that can't move, but it's whatever. You can't step on the crack until we get lower bars. A little bit more. A little bit more. Choice.
A close one.
Yeah, too close.
Well, it looks like we're safe now. And why did I have to say that?
I can't believe I have to mop this whole place every single... What? What are you doing here?
Trying not to be scared. And let me tell you, it's not going well.
Well, me name's Pete Crudgeon. I'm the caretaker of this theater, and I don't need strays hanging about causing trouble.
Stray? Where? Like, sorry, man, but the Queen asked us to help solve this crime.
The Queen? Oh, fine. Just try not to mess up the place.
Hey, that's a pretty fancy mop bucket you got there.
Yeah, I invented it myself. I'm pretty good with electronics. But I have to be the caretaker at this theater because my dad did it, and his dad before him.
Why aren't you home with your family? It's Christmas Eve.
This theater is my home.
Spoiler, I think the janitor is the ghost.
I'm going to eat some beans.
I think the janitor is the ghost.
Beans for Christmas?
Sounds good to me.
Look out, Scoob! Look up there on the catwalk! I hate to say it, but we'd better get up there if we want to solve this mystery.
So I did this like 3 times. Each time, I bugged out right here. Okay, I want to try something different, but I already know. Oh, sticky keys.